Welcome to mygaytoronto.com TV. You're watching In Focus. My name is Angelique Xavier. We are shooting at Lola's today at Yonge and Maitland. And today's guest is the winner of Project Runway Season 2, Sunny Fong. Thanks very much for joining us today.
No problem. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good.
First of all, I have to say congratulations. Now, you know, I talked to a lot of people, and a lot of people thought you were their front runner from the start. So I guess one of the questions I have, a major question, is having won the competition, how did you not spill the beans when you were obligated to keep it a secret?
Lying is good. Start with one lie, just keep on going with the same lie, and it just gets better and better.
Oh.
And then everybody believes the same thing.
So, oh, next thing you're trekking in the Himalayas,
exactly.
You were never there. And what about the people around you, like your mother, your friends, very proud of you?
There was a select few that did know, because, you know, and their lips were sealed as well. But for everybody else, you know, I was away in Hong Kong for like a month. So
that's awesome. And now, I mean, you seemed, I watched the show, and you know, you came off as a really nice person. I'm sure that's how you are. But who do you think was your biggest competition?
Biggest competition? Originally, I thought it was Baylor.
Okay.
Until he got voted off. And I'm like, okay, there he goes. And then I personally thought Jason was my competition.
Yeah.
Because he's a very lucky person. So every time, you know, he got as far as I did, and I was just like, damn, that Jason. and then Jessica crept up, you know, from behind. I'm like, oh, Jessica.
It was a really good top three, though. It was really riveting. Now, you had gone to Ryerson and were in Image Arts. So I was wondering, how does your film background, you know, influence your design?
I reference a lot of films. Like, if anything, I find inspiration through film. Anything that's visual. So that's where I would probably get sort of influence from film. But generally, the film thing was just something I wanted to learn how to do.
Right.
So, and I couldn't teach myself.
Right.
So it's not like so I were you're stitching a straight line. So that's why I did film.
Okay, and so what would you say are some of the movies that maybe have iconic fashion?
Iconic fashion? Gone with the Wind.
Really?
You know, that curtain dress.
I was just thinking that she was able to, but it's like one of those challenges.
Yeah.
Post-it notes, curtain.
Dress. And then there's Sound of Music with the curtains.
So what I'm hearing is your next line might involve some curtains, dreams.
Maybe.
All right. Now, this is going to put you on the spot.
Okay.
We're going to play a little game. It's called Fashion Word Association.
Okay.
So I'm going to say a phrase or a word to do with fashion. You're going to just clear out the first thing that comes out in your mind. Okay. Ready?
Okay.
First one. Leggings as pants.
Yep.
Acid wash.
Ooh.
Kanye for Louis Vuitton shoes.
No. Does that work?
I'll accept that. Judges? Yes.
No.
Okay, we'll accept that. T-shirts with the drawing of a tuxedo on them.
Thank you.
They're cute. White dress shoes?
I like them.
Okay.
Yeah, especially for sure.
Gold lame.
I love it.
Gold lame leggings.
No.
Gold lame leggings as pants.
That's bad. That's worst.
Can you hear that? Do not wear leggings as pants.
Especially on guys.
I've confirmed he's a professional. Do not wear leggings as pants. All right, so.
On guys, on girls, it's fine, but on guys, I've seen it lately, it's just not.
It's just a trend that should not be happening. Now, with all your success recently with the show, and obviously you being a fashion professional aficionado telling us about the leggings pants, what is next? I mean, you had your. Are you going to continue on with Locke, or what's next?
I'm going to continue on with Locke. Locke's my baby, so you know, gotta nurture it. Misbehave for a little bit, so I'm gonna keep on going with Bob. You know, right now I'm developing the business.
Okay.
You know, because I think that was one that was weak.
Right.
So that's one thing I'm just gonna make sure it's strong. As for design, I mean I've got lots of ideas, so there's no problems there.
Can you let us in on an inside scoop of what kind of what kind of things you could be looking at? A little hint?
For spring, summer 2010, I'm looking at something sort of tropical, sort of French Polynesia influence. That's something I'm sort of inspired by right now. So.
That sounds awesome. That. We are definitely looking forward to that. So, Sunny, I just wanted to thank you for taking the time today for speaking with us. And I want to thank you for watching MyGayToronto.com TV. My name is Anjali, and once again, we thank Lola's at Yonge and Maitland for allowing us to be here today. Check our website regularly for the next edition on MyGayToronto.com TV in focus.
Sorry.
You never know where we'll be going or who we'll be bringing to you next.